When we made the body form, we had no plan for it to stand up on its own. Well, I figured that if I could hang it straight, that would enable me to draw a horizontal line around the bottom for trimming. Now, what about that neck shape? I grabbed this shirt and confirmed that I liked the fit on my neck. Ah, man, it was great to see these wrinkles because that's the point of this body form, for me to be able to see issues with a shirt so easily. There are wrinkles I didn't know about until now. I assumed that I would see the same wrinkles in the mirror. And when I looked, no, the wrinkles are different when the shirt is on me. So that means there's an issue with my body form. I went back to the body form, shoved the collar around until the wrinkles matched what I saw in the mirror. This shirt has a neck piece between the collar and the main body. With this collar in place, I drew a line on the body form to match the bottom edge of the neck piece. I decided the solution was to make a fresh mold of my neck and somehow attach that to the rest of the body. It required a bunch of fiddling, but finally I got something close and attached it. My mistake here was that I did a lot of buildup on the neck to smooth it out before testing fit with the real collar. The collar proved that the paper tape neck was too big around. Leaving the collar in place, I went ahead and trimmed a chunk out of the neck and taped the neck together. The diameter is fine, but the back tilt is incorrect. So I want to build that up a little bit. Also, I want to raise the entire height of that top ring because the shirt collar is currently sitting just above the body form. I want them to match. And with all those tweaks, yay, done. Remember that skinny nobody mannequin from the part one video? I want to take that off of the base and somehow get my body form onto that base. Hey, even cooler would be exchangeable. Make one of these body molds for my wife and be able to interchange those two. Watch the next videos.